Hey everyone, I'm Max Dalton, and in this video, I'm going to talk through how to change your YouTube watermark size. YouTube makes it possible for channel owners to add a watermark to their videos. This watermark lives in the lower right corner of your videos and will even turn into a subscribe button if users click it while watching one of your videos on the desktop version of the YouTube website. However, getting your YouTube watermark size just right can be incredibly frustrating because it's easy to end up with a small watermark that people won't even be able to see, like this. So let's walk through what you can do to make sure you end up with a decent sized watermark like this one. Step 1. Open the image editing software of your choice. This can be GIMP, Photoshop, Canva, or something else. In this video, I'm going to use Adobe Spark Post App, which is available for free. Step 2. Set your Canva size to be 800 by 800 pixels. Step 3. Either create or copy in the content that you want to use as your watermark. To avoid ending up with a small watermark, try to make your image touch or come as close as possible to each side of the canvas. For my watermark, I just use my name in large lettering and an off-white square background. Step 4. Save the image as a transparent PNG file. Step 5. With your transparent PNG watermark file saved, open a web browser on your desktop computer and navigate to YouTube.com. Click your account profile image in the upper right corner of your screen and then click Creator Studio in the drop-down menu that appears. The Creator Studio screen opens. Step 6. Click Channel in the menu on the left side of the screen and then click Branding in the drop-down menu that appears. The branding window appears on the right side of the screen. Step 7. Click Add a watermark if you don't currently have a watermark applied to your YouTube channel. Alternatively, if you already have a watermark on your YouTube channel, you'll need to remove it so you can add a new one. The Upload a Watermark window appears. Step 8. Click Choose File. Navigate to the location of your transparent PNG file in the window that appears and then click to select that file as your YouTube channel watermark. A small preview of that file will appear next to the Choose File button. If you don't see a small preview of your image file, it may be because it was greater than 1 megabyte in size. Verify that your file is a transparent PNG or GIF file and not greater than 1 megabyte in size. Click the blue Save button at the bottom of the Add a Watermark window when you're ready to move forward. A preview of your YouTube watermark appears on the screen. Don't panic that it doesn't take up the entirety of the preview box, as this is just a preview. Step 9. Click the blue Save button again in the lower right corner of the window, displaying a preview of your YouTube watermark. You'll return to the branding window where your new watermark should appear in the lower right corner of the preview box. Don't get too excited because this is not a proportional representation of how large the watermark will be when it is displayed on your YouTube videos. Step 10. Adjust the display time and start time fields associated with your YouTube watermark and then click the blue Update button. A blue Saved Successfully banner appears across the top of your screen. The change will be applied instantly, and you can see your new YouTube watermark in action by watching any of the videos on your channel. Congratulations! You've successfully changed your YouTube watermark size and made the biggest watermark YouTube will allow you to make. Thanks for watching. Leave your thoughts and questions in the comment section below. Click the video link on the right side of the screen to check out another video. Click the logo on the left side of the screen to subscribe to this channel to see more great videos like this one.